contact. All those in favor, please raise your hands. This is in favor of a 20-minute presentation on...
Thank you. Adoption of Article 22, which provides significant savings to the town. And that's what we're looking at. We're in a period when the budget is being stretched very tight. There's not a lot of extra. We're coming up on some issues over the next year that are going to be very costly in the loss of some of the support we have in our budget from the AERA funds. And we're frankly looking for ways where we can make an impact on the budget and at the same time being responsible to the employees and the retirees of the town. So there would be a significant savings to the town. Retirees become part of the system that they and the town have already paid for or are paying for and intended to use. The employees of the town pay into Medicare. They pay 1.45% of their wages into Medicare. The town matches that amount. So this is a federal program that we're already paying for. The other benefit of this is there would be a significant reduction in the unfunded retiree health insurance liability. I'll get into that a bit later on. By way of background, since 1986, all new employees of the town paid Medicare taxes. That's the 1.45% that I mentioned. The town pays an equal share of that tax. The current Medicare eligible retirees have the option to remain in the HMO plan or to go into Medicare. 90% of the retirees have elected to go into Medicare. Those who are eligible, 90% of elected to go into Medicare. So we're talking about the 10% who haven't made that choice. Put it in terms of numbers, there are 290 retirees currently. 70 who are ineligible, and they're ineligible because they haven't paid enough into Medicare or they haven't paid at all into Medicare, because they were employed prior to 1986. So there are 218 eligible. Of the 218 eligible, 196 have elected to go into the program. There are 22 who have not. 17 of them we know are Medicare eligible, and there are 5 that we're not sure. So we did our analysis, we based our analysis upon the 17 that we know are eligible to participate in the plan. In providing HMO coverage to Medicare eligible retirees, it costs both the town and the active employees significantly more. The annual premium for a single individual in our HMO Blue plan costs $6,900 a year. The insurance companies, when they're rating the establishing the rates that are going to be paid, look at the composition of the population that is insured. And in doing that, they come up with what they need or what they believe they need to pay the claims, and they will look at a person that is in the 40 to 49 age group, and compare that to somebody that's in the 70 to 74 age group, and the premium that they would need to collect for the person in the 70 to 74 age group on the cover cost is about 2.5 times what it is for someone who's 40, between 40 and 49. The difference between those, so that if you took the $6,900, which is what we pay as the average, multiply that by 2.4, it says that the cost to insure somebody's between 70 and 74 is about $16,500. Of course, this is all blended in so an average rate is developed. But influencing that cost is the excessive cost for insuring someone in that age group. The difference between those two is about $9,600-$9,700. As I said, there are currently 17 Medicare eligible retirees on the town HMO plan, and there may be an additional 5. the cost savings, the total cost savings per year for 17 is about $165,000. It'd be about another $50,000 if the other five people are also Medicare eligible. We're not using that in this calculation. So of the $165,000, that would be shared between the town, the taxpayers, us, and the active employees based upon the participation of the premium. The town pays 70% of the premium, the employees pay 30% of the premium. So of the $165,000, the first year savings for the town would be about $115,000. And the savings that would go to the active employees would be about $50,000. So it's not an insignificant amount of money for either the employees or the town. And additional reductions would be gained each year as more people retire, because they would automatically then go into Medicare like the other 90% of the retirees are. We're not leading the edge at all in considering adopting this proposal. There are better than 140 communities who have already adopted Section 18. There's a list here which shows some of our neighboring communities have already done it. Because somebody else has done it isn't the reason to do it, but it tells you you're not doing something that is really off the mark. Now, there is an impact on the retirees, and I want to address that. The town has an obligation to provide appropriate medical benefits. The combination of Medicare and the Medex plan would be the solution to the medical requirements of the retirees. Our Medex plan is actuarially equivalent to the HMO plan. It covers many of the same costs. There'd be a few differences here and there, but it is what we've been told is a benefit-rich plan. It is not a poor plan at all. They witness the fact that 90% of the retirees are using it. Moving to this schedule would have a cost impact to the retirees. Currently, the retirees who run the HMO are paying about roughly almost $2,100 for their HMO coverage. We move to this proposal, the retirees' costs would change. It would go up for the basic insurance costs. They would subscribe to Part B of Medicare, which would cost them $1,150 a year, and they would subscribe to Medex, which would cost them another almost $2,750. So if you net all of this down, there's about an $1,800 increase cost to the retirees, the 17 individuals that we're talking to. We used the current policy, the policies that are currently in effect to make this measurement. And we use $96, for example, for the Part B. That would go to $110 next year for